And now we return to Christchurch Spitalfields in London.
Welcome back for the second half of tonight's concert from the 1983 Spitalfields Festival of Music, in which we're going to hear the first London performance of Diana Burrell's Missa Sancte Deliente, the Mass of Sede Deliente. It's scored for soloists, two semi-choruses and a main chorus, and a standard symphony orchestra with a very large percussion section. And tonight's soloists are Jennifer Smith, Catherine Denley, Charles Brett, Martin Hill and Stephen Roberts, with the London Symphony Chorus and the City of London Sinfonia leader Malcolm Layfield. The Mass was commissioned by the St. Endelian Festival in Cornwall and received its first performance there in 1980, conducted by tonight's conductor Richard Hickox. Endelianta was a 6th century saint, the daughter of a Welsh king, and according to legend, the goddaughter of King Arthur. And Diana Burrell has incorporated into the traditional Latin Mass a hymn to St. Endelianta by the 17th century hagiographer Nicholas Ross Carrick, and sections of the liturgy in Cornish. The composer had two aims in view. First, to solve the formal problems of balance imposed by the traditional Latin text, in which the two weightiest movements come early on, with the shorter, more meditative, less theological texts coming at the end. And secondly, to contrast the light of Christianity with the Dark Ages. In the composer's words, to juxtapose St. Endelianta's world, its cruelties, superstitions, and magic, with the formality of the Christian liturgy. To depict the sheer force of the spiritual and intellectual growth and the conflicts that must have accompanied the birth of the early church. Diana Burrell employs many devices to create a feeling of unity, apart from the traditional use of similar music for the Kyrie and Agnus Dei, the opening and closing sections. Much of the music is derived from a four-note motto, F, F-sharp, E, and G. Again, many other figures and motifs recur at significant points of the text. Very often a new idea is introduced at the end of a movement and will be developed in the next. The Kyrie is given out almost entirely by the soloists, the chorus entering only in the last six bars. In contrast to this simplicity, the Gloria is multi-layered, with the various vocal groupings shouting, chanting, whispering and singing both the Latin and Cornish texts. The Credo is more severe, much play being made of three distinct types of music representing the three persons of the Holy Trinity. The belief in the three persons reaffirmed in Cornish before the final Amen. In an attempt to shift the centre of musical gravity, Diana Burrell has developed the Sanctus to become the climax of her Mass setting. It's preceded by Nicholas Ross Carrick's Hymn to St. Endelianta. The hymn itself introduced by fragmentary signs and the Sanctus text whispered in both Latin and Cornish. After the hymn, the music develops into an elaborated version of the famous instrumental passage between the Sanctus and Benedictus in Beethoven's Missa Solemnis. The Sanctus proper develops into a huge climax, and the Benedictus is intoned by the tenor soloist. The contemplative Agnus Dei ends as the whole work had begun, with the solo viola, which is the composer's own instrument. And so we're about to hear the Missa Sancte Deliente by Diana Burrell. That was the first performance in London of the Mass of Saint Endelianto, the Missa Sancte Endelianto by Diana Barry, given here at the Spitalfields Festival by Jennifer Smith, Catherine Denley, Charles Brett, Martin Hill and Stephen Roberts. The London Symphony Chorus and the City of London Symphonia, conducted by Richard Hickox. And from Christchurch, Spitalfields and the East End of London, I'll say good night.